Good morning, Mustangs, and welcome to the Mustang News in the Morning. I'm Amber Lewis.
And I'm Sharon Fons. Thank you, Mrs. Lamb's third period, for participating in our pledge segment. Now let's see what Amber's up to with our megabytes. Not sure what to get for lunch today? You can choose between a chicken taco salad with tortilla chips, garlic flatbread pizza, or garden vegetable salad. Don't forget to side your meals with fresh fruits and vegetables. All right, guys, so let's see what Mitchell students had to say about their Thanksgiving break with Danny Ramslin.
What up, Mustangs? It's Danny Ramslin reporting live from Mustang News in the Morning. As you can see, we're back in school now, so I was curious as to how your Thanksgiving breaks went. Let's see what you have to say. So what did you do over your Thanksgiving break?
Hello, this is Ms. Raconage. I wanted to fill you in on what I did during Thanksgiving break. I was lucky enough to go to the Bahamas with my daughters, and I have proof. I met with Dolphin Exuma. So, next Thanksgiving, you may think of going to the Bahamas as well.
What did you do on Thanksgiving Day?
On Thanksgiving Day, I got myself a 10-point buck. Thanksgiving Day, I watched football.
And what did you do on your Black Friday?
I had a pretty good Black Friday. I didn't really pay for too much of anything. I kind of stole everything. I learned how to climb a fence.
Get away from me. Get away from me.
There you have it, Mustangs. I hope you had a good break. I know I did. I'm Danny Ramslin. Back to you in the studio.
Today in Random News, I know we've all heard horror stories about grave robbers, but did you ever think that they were for real? Tomb raiders in southern Africa have dug up more than 100 graves in a cemetery in Benin since Saturday for what authorities suspect is a black market trade in human organs and skulls for voodoo ritual fetishes. Authorities in Dangbo said that the investigation began after a mason working at the cemetery said that he spotted several masked men digging up graves from which organs and skulls were removed. Body parts of humans and rare animals are prized by some people in Central Africa for their supposed supernatural powers and are used in occult ceremonies. Traffickers often obtain human remains from grave robbers, but a recent spate in killings has also been linked to the gruesome trade. On Tuesday, I went with some of our ESE students to the horse farm. Here's a little bit of footage covering the trip.
Hey, Mustang, Sharon Fons here reporting for the Mustang News in the Morning. Yesterday, I went on a field trip with some of our students with exceptionalities. We went over to the horse farm. Here's a little bit of footage to see what happened.
Everyone who went yesterday had an amazing time, and thank you to everyone who volunteered their time yesterday. Back to you guys in the studio.
Today in Worldwide News, experts released a study yesterday that puts to rest the debate over whether the poles added to or subtracted from sea level rise. With this improved clarity, it allows scientists to say that both Antarctica and Greenland have been rapidly losing ice. Most of the loss is in Western Antarctica, where an iceberg the size of New York City is set to calve off. Thinning glaciers mean that ice on the mainland can make its way downhill into the sea a lot faster. Greenland is losing mass at about 5 times the rate today as it was in the early 1990s. This new information is calling for plans and negotiations for seawalls and other ideas. Now let's see what Carly's up to in the sports cage.
Hey Mustangs, it's Carly Dampier here in the sports cage. Our basketball girls had an exciting game last night against Tampa Catholic. The game started off slow as the Mustangs were down 25-4. They then rallied back at the half, and with only 7 seconds left on the clock, Hannah Christen's amazing shot, while there were only 7 seconds on the clock and falling out of bounds, then made them go in overtime. The game ended with the girls shutting out Tampa Catholic 65-60. The stars of the game were Ashley Lewis with 21 points and Kim Newton with 14 in overtime. Their next game is on Tuesday at River Ridge, so everyone needs to get ready to go out and represent our Mitchell Maniacs and support our basketball girls. Attention all Mitchell sports fans, sports pass prices have been reduced just for the holidays. You can now purchase a 10-game pass for just $20. That is just $2 per game. Today, the boys wrestling travel out to Eastlake for a wrestling tournament. As well, the basketball boys travel out to Winter Haven, and the soccer team will be traveling to River Ridge High School. And the basketball and soccer both start at 6 p.m. That is all the sports updates for today. Manoli and I attended the in-school wrestling match on Wednesday. So now let's check out this quick footage of our wrestlers.
Hey, I'm Carly Damp here outside of the wrestling match, Mitchell versus River Ridge. So let's go check it out. Best of luck to the rest of your season. Back to you guys in the studio.
Today in local news at the Hernando County Fairgrounds, starting today at 6 p.m., you can drive through a light display called Candy Cane Acres. You can also enjoy and park and enjoy the festive grounds. Prices are $10 per car load, which includes 10 free tickets, and additional tickets are 50 cents each. Now let's move it over to Sharon in the Daily Blog.
So today with the weather, this weekend this is the forecast, and Saturday we have 0% chance of rain along with Sunday, and it's 80 degrees both days and it's 60 to 61 for the lows. And if you take a look here at the beach forecast, the UV index is at a moderate 5 and the wind speed is 10 to 17 miles per hour. The sunset is at 5:34 both days, but that's it for now. Let's send it over to Nika Stead with the on scene. Sorry for the technical difficulties, but we don't have on scene today. Today, this is the weather picture of the day from Anthony LeBaron, and he took this after wrestling practice the other day. Thanks for the great picture, Anthony. Have a great weekend.
Teachers, if you would like your class to be featured in the Daily Plug segment, please email Mr. Whitaker. Thank you for tuning in to the Mustang News in the Morning. Have an amazing day. I'm Amber Lewis.
And I'm Sharon Fonts. Have a good weekend.
An empty house. So hold my hand, I'll walk with you, my dear.
The stairs creak as you sleep, it's keeping me awake.
It's the house telling you to close your eyes.
And some days I can't even trust myself.
It's killing.